Hello and welcome. This video is about 3D geoinformation for sustainable urban development. The main focus is on the organizational and legal challenges of 3D spatial data infrastructures. Spatial data infrastructures are just like road infrastructures, which help road users arrive at their destination. Spatial data infrastructures help the user of spatial data to arrive at various objectives. For instance, managing traffic flows in and between urban areas, measuring and reducing air pollution, and identifying potential unsafe or dangerous neighborhoods. To realize these kinds of objectives, multiple types of data need to be combined, which implies that the datasets involved must be interoperable. Not only interoperable from a technical standpoint, but also from a legal and organizational standpoint. First, I will address some of the challenges that users face, and second, some challenges facing data providers. Let's assume we want to have an overview of all the windmills near the city. Maybe there are several organizations that provide this data, but they all use a different definition of the term windmill. Which definition is useful to reach the objective? An example of this lack of interoperability is the noise map of the Dutch provinces. Various provinces use different definitions to map the noise along the freeways. If someone wants to use this data at the national level, how does he decide how much noise pollution is there along the Dutch freeways? Using the data provided by the different sources, it's hard to obtain a complete picture of the actual situation. It's clear that a 3D spatial data infrastructure also requires consistent noise data, but in 3D, which involves collecting and standardizing even more data. In this image, you'll see in red, orange and green the noise near a new road. What we can learn from this image is where noise levels have to be reduced. Users of spatial data need to be familiar with the various issues related to data collection. They also need to know where to find the data and whether they are allowed to use the data. For example, what are the legal constraints when it comes to using data? Sometimes data can only be used after a complex legal contract is signed. If data is provided without any restriction, it's known as open data. The question remains if it's allowed to combine the restrictive data with the open data. How do you know? To answer that question, you need to read the license terms. Within a strictly national context, resolving technical and legal questions regarding data licenses may be easy to resolve. But what if you are operating in an international context? Is the data collected in the same way in Germany as it is in the Netherlands? And are the rules regarding the use of the data the same? Using 3D data for sustainable urban development also poses challenges to a 3D data infrastructure and its data providers. These challenges can be summarized as collect it once, use it many times. What it means is that it is important to operate as efficiently as possible. For instance, by making sure the same data isn't collected twice. This requires communication and cooperation among government agencies, citizens, and the market. Reaching agreement on data collection is especially difficult when there are several organizations already collecting identical data, which raises the following questions. What should be the primary source and who should stop collecting data? Who should govern the data set and who should govern the data infrastructure? What resources need to be shared, how, when, and with whom? Furthermore, what are the consequences of sharing data? Not only the technical consequences, but also the legal consequences and the organizational and business consequences. To summarize, within the context of sustainable urban development, it is smart to adopt a clear definition, for example, for windmills. It's important for the organizations currently providing data to understand and accept the need for fine-tuning. These and many more challenges are a daily reality of the 2D spatial data infrastructure practice, and they also need to be addressed in a 3D context. Good data governance is needed. Only then the spatial data infrastructure can be the foundation for efficient and proper governance and decision-making for sustainable urban development.